स्टूडेंट आई किशोर सिंह चौहान वेलकम यू ऑल इन टुडेज सोशल साइंस क्लास। इन टुडेज सोशल साइंस क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू चैप्टर नंबर 4 ऑफ क्लास 6 फ्रॉम सिविक स्ट्रीम एंड द टाइटल ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज की एलिमेंट्स ऑफ डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट। स्टूडेंट वी हैव लर्नड दैट आवर कंट्री हैज अ फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट एंड दैट फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इज कॉल्ड representative democracy। So in this chapter, as I told you, we are going to learn the key elements of democratic government। So before we start discussing the key elements of a democratic form of government, let's recall what is democratic government। Student Abraham Lincoln, who was one of the greatest presidents of the USA, defined democracy as government of the people, by the people, and for the people, that you have learnt in previous chapter। So this is what actually happens in representative democracy only, and as I told you, our nation is also representative democracy। The adult citizen choose members of the government from among themselves in the form of MLAs, okay, they form state government, in the form of MPs, they form central or union government, means through election process। So there is government of the people, by the people, okay, again the chosen members like MPs, MLA, they take decision on behalf of and for the benefits of the people। So this is government for the people। So democracy or democratic government means government, okay, in which citizen of nation participate as the representative, take decision, make laws and run their nation, okay, through representative means MLAs or MP। Now we are going to discuss the important key features of democratic government। So student, there are specific key elements of democratic government which we are going to learn in this chapter। First, that is participation। Second, that is equality। Then next is justice, and not the least, but next is resolve conflict। So let's start with the very first key element, and that is participation। Student, in a democracy, okay, the people participate। Now how people participate, because participation is one of the key element। So in democratic country, the people participate in making the laws that affect them। How they do this? Usually through the elected representative, means in election by giving vote they elect representative, and these representative make laws, okay। So the government is elected for a fixed period of time, that we know very well, and in our nation government is elected for 5 years। Once elected, the government can stay in power for that period of time, okay, that means 5 years, and at the end of that period election are held again after 5 years, okay, in state, for state government, and at all over nation, that is for central government। If the people are satisfied with the government, means program, policies, decision, so they may re-elect, okay, and if they are not, then they may elect another government, okay। So this gives the people the power to change a government that cannot satisfy। So this is the first way of participation, through election, okay। Second thing, that in democratic country the people can criticize the government, this is only possible in democratic form of government। We discussed the types of government in previous chapter, monarchy system, dictatorship। So in monarchy and dictatorship, these types of freedom is not possible, means criticizing the government. Okay, so how this criticize or how people can criticize? So people can express their views through different media. You understand very well, like newspaper, television, films and so on. Okay, on television, in especially if I talk about news channel, you see that there are some animation regarding the government, prime ministers and other ministers. Okay, then you have also watched or you have also seen films. Okay, then cartoons in newspaper. So in this way, by using different media, people can criticize. Okay, they can also participate. So this is the next form of participation, means people can participate in various forms of protest. And what type of protest? Means rallies, signature campaigns, strike and other form of, okay, there you can say criticizing government. Now we are going to discuss about the next key element, that is freedom. Look, student, it is often said that there is no democracy without freedom. Yes, this is very, very true. Okay, democracy can survive or you can say exist if there is freedom. Freedom here means freedom of speech and expression. Means people are free to express their view, opinion, okay, in favor of government, against the government, program, policy, decision. So they are completely free. Freedom to practice the religion of one's choice, means we are free in our nation to follow any religion of our choice. Okay, then next is freedom to do any job, means for my livelihood I am completely free to do any kind of job or any kind of occupation. And there are number of freedom also available, but these freedom can be exercised in what way? Do you think that these types of freedom can be exercised in any way? No. Okay, these forms of, or you can say these freedom can be exercised in a proper way or in a democratic manner. You can say democratic manner means that without breaking any law, means we are not free that to follow our or to get our freedom that we can break any law. No, we are not, okay, means we are completely free to follow our freedom, but we need to follow our country's law and without harming others also. So after freedom, the next key element, that is equality and justice. And this is another important key elements of democratic government. Student, the picture on your screen is clearly showing you that what is equality and what is justice. Okay, as we know that in a democratic country, everybody is equal before the law. Everybody means whether he or she a government official, businessman or even the president, means we all are equal before the law. Okay, no one is above the law. Therefore the laws are not different for different people, means we all are equal against the law or before the law, and there is no one above the law. Okay, everybody in our nation, okay, enjoys equal status and gets equal opportunity for different purpose, like for study, for earning their living and for different things. Okay, in a democracy, everybody we know has the right to get justice. Now justice means fair treatment. Okay, if any person faces discrimination for any reason, so he or she can seek justice in court of law. Okay, so this is the next and very important feature of democratic government, that is equality and justice. Now we are going to discuss the another important key element, that is need to resolve conflict. Okay, so student, an important role of government, which type of government I am talking here? The democratic government. So this is the important role of government to resolve conflict between various groups within nation. As we know that our nation, India, is a diverse nation. We have number of religion, languages, food, culture, tradition, festivals. So obviously, okay, there will be conflict. Okay. So here, whose important role to resolve this conflict? Again, government. Okay. Conflict arise. We know when conflict arise. These conflict arise when people of different religions, as I told you, India is a diverse nation. So when people of different religions, reason means area or economic background, poor, rich, middle class, okay, strongly disagree with each other. Okay. So these types of, okay, just take example from your family or from your, you can say, friend circle. Okay, in our family also, okay, suppose a family of 4 member or 5 member, father, mother, brother, sister, okay. So sometime on some issue, okay, what happened? We also disagree with each other. So here, who play very important role? Obviously, in our family, our elders play very important role, means parents, father, mother, grandfather or grandmother. So same thing, same role of government in a democratic, okay, form of government. So government is to resolve conflict between various groups. Okay, and what happens sometime in our family also, when we strongly disagree with each other, so conflict turns into violent. Okay, so same thing can be happen in our nation. So here the role of government is very, very important. Now how government will resolve? The government takes steps to prevent conflicts from turning violent. This is the job, duty of government. Okay, whenever there is a large gathering of people, we saw normally, okay, in television or in real life also, okay, of different groups. So policemen, you see na, number of policemen watch over the crowd. Okay, so why this happened? You must have noticed a large number of policemen around whenever, okay, you have watched a religious procession in our society, in our colony, in our region, okay, or an election rally. Yes, mainly in election rally. Okay, or even a cricket match or football match between 2 popular teams. So who is trying not to happen this type of conflict among the people? Yes, obviously government is playing this role. So in India, our nation, okay, as in other democratic countries also, conflicts are resolved according to the laws. Okay, different countries, they have different laws to resolve these conflicts. So similarly in our nation, we have laws to resolve the conflict. Okay, so and these laws apply to all groups equally, whether a particular group is in majority or a group is in minority, it doesn't matter. Means the laws to resolve conflicts apply to all groups equally. Okay, so now we are going to discuss that what is democracy and the Indian Constitution. Democracy term is very much clear to all of you. Okay, now if we talk about the Constitution, Constitution, as you know very well, we have discussed in the previous chapter also, the set of supreme law. Okay, that is Constitution. So in our Constitution, the preamble. Now what is preamble? Preamble means the introduction of India's Constitution. Okay, so the preamble clearly states that India is a democratic republic. What is written very clearly? That India is a democratic republic, or in another word we can say that it is a democratic country with an elected head of state. Means here, who is the head of our state? Our nation, president. And he is not appointed, he is head of our country as which process? Through election. So the preamble, okay, also state that the Constitution aims to give all Indian citizens what the things these are: justice, okay, on the basis of social, economic and political, then you can say liberty. Liberty means freedom, okay, of thought, of expression, belief, faith and worship. And the last, not the least, equality on the basis of states, status and opportunity. Opportunity for study, for job and other things. So this is all about this chapter, okay. So thank you and have a nice day to all of you.